Hello, adventure rider from around the world. In the last week, I got the chance to ride this beautiful Honda Africa Twin Adventure around Bulgaria. I did more than 2000 kilometers on any kind of terrains. I believe that I already know what it is and I'm ready to share my opinion. So if you have nothing to do, grab a beer and watch the video. Stay with me. Welcome back. If you don't know me, my name is Pavlin and I'm a motorcycle traveler. In this channel, I usually upload anything related to long motorcycle trips, so you might consider subscribing. The motorcycle was provided to me from Rosetta Moto Tours. This is actually a company that makes motorcycle tours around Bulgaria. We just came back an hour ago and I came here to record this video. The week went just like that. Poof! It was so interesting. I'm so glad that I met these guys because they offer unique service. Honestly, guys, they offer unique service. I've been to many places, I rode with many companies, but the service like that you can't find anywhere. In the next few days, I'm gonna edit all the videos that I record during the trip and I'm gonna list it in my channel so you can see with your eyes what exactly I'm talking about. Back on the topic, how good is this Honda Africa Twin Adventure? Well, actually, it's very good. Oh man, it's so hot here. Let me check. It is 37 degrees here on the shade. Man, it's a hot day in Bulgaria. And I still have the dust on the top of the motorcycle. All right, as I said, in the last 1 week, I've done more than 2000 kilometers on any kind of terrains. What I missed was the dirt roads. I've got about just a little 200-300 meters. That's why now when I finish talking, I'm gonna ride on this light dirt track here just to show you what is possible to have with this bike. You have to consider one very important thing. This is very, very heavy motorcycle. Without any luggage, it's 250 kilograms, 247. When you have 20-30 kilograms of luggage, we're talking about 260-70 kilograms. Yes, you cannot feel it while you ride on the beautiful roads, but you feel it when you need to push it, to lift it on the central stand, even to lift it from your side stand, you feel it, especially when you have full tank and luggage. So this is not a motorcycle for experiments. It's not a motorcycle for tiny, light people. It's a big, big monster. All right, let me give you some specifications now, briefly to tell you about specifications, and then I'm gonna jump on it and ride it for you just to show you what exactly it is. Let me start with the overall design. Beautiful bike. I have nothing else to say. Beautiful. The colors that you can see now are handmade for the company that I told you. This actually symbolizes the colors of Bulgarian flag. White, green and red. But anyway, the design, wonderful. Everything is made absolutely great with the idea that this bike is going to be ridden everywhere around the world. I cannot say any bad words. It has a tall windscreen. Of course, it has this wonderful sticker. This is the sticker of Rosetta Moto Tours. And they add these additional things here on the left and right hand side. And they actually make significant difference in your riding comfort. I can confirm that it works absolutely wonderful. Upside down suspension, very, very good. 21 inch front wheel. 320 millimeters double disc, Nissin brake calibers. It has 18 inch on the rear side and it has 270 on the rotor is 270 millimeters. The brakes are outstanding. The brakes are absolutely great. Two things I can tell you immediately. This bike runs very well and stops very well. This is absolutely no doubt. The design of the seat is very good. It is on two levels and after more than a week, I can say that it's absolutely fine. You can change it if you like, but you don't have to. It's all right. The tank is 24 liters and it gives you range more than 500 kilometers. I confirmed many times. The forks are adjustable from here. You can make some kind of preload. Also, you can adjust it from this, from the bottom as well. The suspension now is set to soft. I left it to soft because it is very good when you ride on the road. For bumpy roads, dirt roads, probably you need to tighten it a little bit. But for normal usage, it's fine. The engine, 1000cc, 998 to be more precise. Parallel twin, It has something like 95 or 96 horsepower, but guys, this is more than enough. I did not have any problem anywhere on any road with this power. For me, it's more than enough, but maybe I'm not an example because I'm all right even with 48 horsepower. But the power, it's perfect. The pegs are very, very good, wide enough, and this rubber helps when you ride for so many kilometers to eliminate some kind of vibrations. The brake pedal, it's not foldable, but it is small enough, you can't really break it. This crash guard is not stock, it's not original, it is from Outback. Very, very good quality, free support points, really, really tough. One of the days, one of the guys just dropped the bike and it was absolutely perfectly covered with this, no problem whatsoever. The stock exhaust is really big, but I love the sound. Let me show you. And if it's mine, I will never change it. Listen now. I love it, it's just so good. And I really like the design of the wheels, these golden wheels. Everything reminds you about the classic Africa Twin. Wide handlebar, 28 millimeters, really tough, really comfortable. Let me sit on it to show you. Even without any adjustments, I felt good, but it already has some kind of bar risers. After a minute, I'm gonna show you how exactly it suits me ergonomically, but let me show the dashboard. Beautiful, beautiful design. I don't know what you will be able to see now here, but there is so many different options and features. You can control everything from here. To be honest, guys, for 1 week, I did not check anything. Anything. I never changed anything and I never checked anything. The only thing that I lowered it down a little bit was the traction control. The maximum level is 7, I made it to 5 and I did not touch anything else. I don't have to. There is a big button here so you can turn off the ABS of the rear wheel if you like to. The rest is very simple, start and kill button, anything else. They have a heated grips on this model from this button, which is very, very useful, very nice, light and small, and I really like the design. The mirrors are beautiful, the visibility is very good. The windscreen, as I said, wonderful, wonderful. Absolutely great with this extension here. It did absolutely great job. These are the passenger handles. And of course, this is the bottom part of Givi top case. Of course, I asked them to remove it because I don't need it while I ride. I was here with my horseshoe back. The passenger pack, again, comfortable, big. This is actually for hard panniers, if you like to have. Overall design, absolutely great. It comes with these handguard protectors from plastic. If you plan some kind of serious traveling around the world, it will be a good idea to change it. But anything else, it's great. I really like the option that the indicators always stay light while you ride. It's very good. The headlight, very, very good design. Here is absolutely amazing. I love everything. I love the color of this forks here. I also like the rear side, the tile. See, it's clear, not that big, not that heavy. And as I said, the overall design, wonderful. It has two radiators, one here and one on the other side, and it has some kind of guard, plastic guard. I don't think that you will need anything else. I think that is enough. As I said, this is not stock. This is stock, I believe. I'm not so sure. The bolts are missing because they use different crash guards. The crash guards that are coming with the bike are not that solid. That's why they decided to change it. Okay, let me show you now how it suits to someone with my size. All right. I am 185, little above 6 foot, and I have absolutely flat feet. The seat got two levels. I believe that I have it now on the lower level, but the seat was something like 86 or 87 centimeters. I'm gonna check it and write it down in the video later. The position is absolutely perfect for me. I don't need to change anything. I rode it like this for 1 week. No problems whatsoever. So is it for short guys? I don't think so. Usually the short guys are also light guys, and I don't believe that this is a motorcycle for light and short guys because of its massive size. I don't really like this huge petrol tank because you actually need to spread your knees like that to sit, but that's me. Some people love it. That's everything that I would like to say. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like the video. What? Riding? Of course, I'm joking. Now I'm gonna jump on this monster and ride it to show you what exactly it is capable to do. I cannot believe that it started even raining. Man, it was so hot for whole week. And now, when I decided to ride here, it started raining and maybe it will be worse. So, let's go as fast as possible. All right, as I told you guys, I'm not gonna make any crazy stuff. Okay, first let me turn off this ABS. Press and hold. ABS is off. I'll make traction control on 2. And then I can go. Because with this traction control, you cannot really ride it on such a terrain. So, as I said guys, it is a heavy motorcycle and you have to have this in mind. Because, let me close my visor, okay. Because it is not that easy to control it, especially if you have more difficult terrains. For something like this, what I ride now, it's alright. It's perfectly manageable because the suspension is very good. Even that now is set to soft, it is still alright. Even a pleasure to ride on such a terrains. Alright, let's see here. On the smooth dirt tracks like this, oh, absolutely blast and pleasure. On the gravel, absolutely perfect. But if you have to do something more technical, then you really feel the weight, especially when you need to make maneuvers, U-turns, jumping from side to side or many more like that. That's why, as I said guys, it's a heavy, heavy beast. But for something like this, what I do at the moment, absolutely no problem whatsoever. I will advise for those who are not really familiar with anything that mainly they don't have much experience with off-road riding to leave the traction control on, because it might put you on a real trouble if you don't know what to do. It's a very powerful machine, and traction control really helps. Okay, let's check some bumps here. More like big stones. Alright, it's alright. So as I said guys, I'm not gonna go into much more harder than this. First of all, it is not my motorcycle. It is not fair for the guys from Rosetta Moto Tours. And I just wanted to show you that light off-road like this, it is not a problem at all. So I'm gonna U-turn here now and go back on the street to show you where the real power of this motorcycle is. And overall, I'm surprised how well they balance this motorcycle. Even that it is heavy, even that it has this big petrol tank, and now the petrol is completely full. I filled it up maybe 2 kilometers before I came to this point, and it still handle all of these bumps really good. And yeah, I think Honda make really good job, but it is heavy. So for anything else different than what I'm riding now, I'll suggest go and take something light, because this will be just too much, or at least this is my opinion. And maybe I'm not right. I'm sure that there will be many professional guys that they will ride it absolutely without any problems. They will jump with it and anything else. But the average Joe, it's not ready to do such a experiment. That's why I said the power of this motorcycle, it's not here. The power of this motorcycle, it's on the road. And just in a minute, I'm gonna show you what exactly I mean. The power is very nice. The sound and everything is just perfect. And my beautiful country, whatever you decide, you can go and ride off-road. This is not possible in Europe, not possible in Germany. For anything else, you have to go and pay it. Not in Bulgaria. at least for now. Maybe this will change in the future, I don't know. Like anything else, we go in the same direction, European Union, and that's it. Alright, I hope I'm not gonna damage the wheels. Now I'm on the road. Let me adjust the traction control to 5. Alright, now I'm ready to ride. First I will start with these bumpy roads. And as I said guys, the suspension at the moment is soft and it is comfortable. Especially when you have bumps, potholes like this, you can fly over it without any problems. Look at now, it works absolutely wonderful. Look at this, like a ship, like a spaceship. Back on the roads, man, I like the power. Now I am on fourth gear and have a look now. It's pulled like a blast and stop so well. The power is perfect and the brakes are perfect. Two combinations, very very important. Just in a minute I'll go on the highway and we'll twist even more to show you what are the possibilities, but for roads like this it's absolutely pleasure. I mean country roads, because here you don't feel the weight, it is just so balanced bike. Let me take this now here. Look at my beautiful country. Oh man, I love Bulgaria. See the power? Perfect. As I told you guys, the riding position is so comfortable. Visibility is very good. Front, mirrors, everything. You can see the dashboard, how well it is. And it doesn't matter, you have a front light, back light, you always see it. All the buttons are here, wonderful. It also has a self-canceling indicators, which is absolutely perfect. And yeah, for trips like this, going around, have a look at the sunflowers, my beautiful country Bulgaria. Let me now go to the twisty roads to show you how it shines over there. Another big bonus is the petrol consumption. You can see what it is now, 5.1 liters, considering that I'm coming from the dirt roads. But when you ride it on the normal roads, it's under 5, usually it's 4.7, 4.8 liters per 100 kilometers. And I've done this for 2000 kilometers. Never exceed 5 liters for such a heavy motorcycle. It's a very, very good result. For city riding, commuting, yeah, why not? If you don't mind the size, if you don't mind the kilograms, comfortable seat, straight position, you're on the top of the cars, good visibility. Yeah, absolutely good. Around the neighborhood, yeah, it's alright. Maybe a little bit problem when you need to park it, but if you're a tough guy, why not? Let me show you now where is the power of this motorcycle. Twisty rolls, like this. It has so much power and so good brakes that rolls like this are just perfect. Traction control just controlled me now. It's a blast, pleasure to ride. wonderful. See now the brakes. Absolutely blast. And see now maneuvers. Big, huge motorcycle. See how maneuver is. And finally, see my beautiful Bulgaria. Brakes. Absolutely blast. All right, the final test, now we'll go to the highway. By the way, riding position is also very good. Without any bar risers, I feel very, very good, very comfortable. The foot pegs are wide enough. Yeah, absolutely fine. Two things I don't really like on this motorcycle. First is the weight. Yeah, it is balanced, it's run very well, it stops very well, but it's such a heavy, very, very heavy. Especially when you need to push it up, and I need to do it a couple of times on this trip, and I really appreciate light motorcycles. The second is the indicator switch. It is under the horn. On all motorcycles are the other way around. The horn is on the bottom, the indicator is on the top. But after a few days you get used to. This is not a big problem. To ride it on the roads like this with 90 kilometers per hour, which is the limit for this type of roads, pleasure. Now I'm on 6th gear. I don't need even to change the gears. You can easily overtake. You can spend all day sitting on 6th gear. Honestly, if you have roads like this. Now I'm on the way to the highway, just to show you how distressed the engine is, because now at the moment, okay, let's ride with 90 kilometers per hour. It is with 2600 RPMs. 2600 RPMs with 90 kilometers per hour. This is nothing to this motorcycle, because it has how many? 10,000 RPMs. Nothing. 100 kilometers per hour, 3500 RPM. 6th gear. Very, very good result. 100 kilometers per hour, wind protection is very, very good. Yeah, it is noisy, but my helmet is noisy and I have really hard side wind, but the wind protection is perfect. Okay, I'm gonna take the highway now. Man, it has so much power. And 20 kilometers per hour with 4,200 RPM. 140, 150 with 5,000 RPM. So you can easily ride it with 150 if you like. It is right in the middle of the scale. I don't know, are you able to hear me now, but I'm riding with 140 and I have this dual bolt helmet. Wind protection, yeah, it's very, very good. All right, no more. Enough pushing for this motorcycle for today. My conclusion. Do I plan to buy this motorcycle? No. Few reasons. Two. Very expensive and very heavy. That's everything. It is not for me. For my type of trips. I travel alone, sometimes I go to difficult terrains, and I want to be able to push the bike, lift the bikes many times if possible. This is just too heavy and too expensive for me. I cannot afford to damage it. But it is wonderful machine, wonderful machine. For those who travel mostly 90% on the asphalt, with a pillion, with a lot of luggage, yes, it is perfect opportunity. If I have to compare this to BMW GS 1250, last year I've got the chance to ride the GS for 3 days, now I've got the chance to ride this motorcycle for 1 week. And honestly guys, in my opinion, I prefer to have the Honda. The GS is just not for me. I cannot explain why, but I feel better with this Honda. I feel more comfortable, and I don't have any more explanation, but it is what it is. So, wonderful machine, but not for me. Thank you very much for spending the time on my channel. I want to say once again huge thank you to the guys from Rosetta Moto Tours that they organized this trip for me, gave me the chance to ride this motorcycle and also show you this huge complex. This is the biggest historical park of the world. It's on the size of 30 acres and they will build even more. They just opened it last year and make a huge, huge progress. It's a wonderful place. In the next few days, as I said, I'm gonna make many, many detailed videos about the trip, detailed episodes, and also we'll make a video inside of this park. And if you have the chance to come here around Varna, this is around 40 kilometers west from Varna, come and see it. You can see Bulgarian, real Bulgarian history, Neolud village, first Bulgarian kingdom, second Bulgarian kingdom. Wonderful. That's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time. Ciao.